What a laugh this has turned out to be. As usual, I've decided to sod it, let's just pull it apart and do what I want to do. Want to try and figure out where the hell the backlight feed from for this was coming from, because I just couldn't understand it for love nor money. Couldn't find any wires to come off the back of that, besides the one going to power it, earth it, and the one that actually came from the point at the back of the car to make it work at all. I ended up pulling all this bit here apart because there's no access there to see what the hell you're looking at, so it's all done by feel. Ended up finding how to take this off. It's literally a matter of the upper trim has two slidey clips, and then there's a screw on that corner, and here if you pull the S-tray out, and basically the rev counter has been put in a hole in the dash here. It's been literally hacked out to make it fit, so it's a very, very tight fitment in there in the first place. Seeing these little clips here, just hold this panel in that needs replaced anyway, so I may well take this opportunity to do that now, to be fair. But anyway, the reason why I couldn't find the feed was because this is the bulb that came out of it, and I've always wondered why the hell there was a wire going to the front of the car through the dashboard. Well, it goes here, all the way along here, and it's this little wire here that's actually been soldered into the front side light. I do not understand the mentality that went through someone's head and thought, yes, let's run a wire from the side lights when there's a blooming dash panel here that's got that should have a wire come off the back of it. Oh, what a total laugh. So yeah, I've now pulled the whole dashboard apart. I've now understood how half the wiring on this car works. I suppose that's a bonus. There has been some rattling going on in the front of this car for ages, ever since I started driving, in fact. I've never quite understood what it was, except for the fact that if I did this through the little holes in here, it stopped. I've now worked out why. If we look down the bottom here, you'll see the two bottom screws, one of which is a flat, if I get the right place, and the other is actually a Phillips. The top hasn't even got a pair of screws in it. So funny enough, if you hold that nice and firm like that, that doesn't now move. What a laugh. I'm actually starting to wonder who the hell has been in here before me, because someone obviously has, and they've not actually put the car all the way back together properly. This is going to explain a lot of rattles that have been doing my head in for a long time and give me an almighty headache. So it's annoying, but actually also quite satisfying, and hopefully it's going to result in a much better return at the end of it. And matters just get worse and worse. I literally have just pulled this to realise actually maybe the reason why it rattled is because you've got this little paper gasket in here, and I reckon if I was to potentially take that out as a template, cut a new one out of say fresh gasket paper that's like quite a bit thicker maybe, that's going to pad that and hopefully prevent it rattling at all, because I won't be playing it. As I was messing around with that, the bottom screw has literally just fallen straight out. Wow, this explains so much. Oh god, I suppose I'll call this a bit of a success. The two bolts either side hole and speedo in place were actually both loose as well, undid them straight away with a pair of long nose pliers. So another reason for it to have been, rattling around. This is a gasket that basically goes between there and there. I'm going to go and make a new one of these out of some fresh gasket paper. It's not going to obviously have this bit on the back that's currently just disintegrating in my hand, but hopefully it's going to obviously tighten everything up and hopefully eliminate the rattling going on. And then what I'm going to try and do is find some very small bolts, probably some little M5s I reckon, or M4s even, and see if I can find some that will fit in those holes. Maybe I have to put a washer or something by my head to pack it out a little bit, but either way, anything that makes it all secure is going to be better than how it is now. So yeah, I'm going to find some of that, and then we can make this make this car a lot better than it's ever been. Now we are going to make some use out of an old Apple Pie box I've been hoarding. I've got about a good few of these things, along with old cereal boxes, because these things are made of a certain type of cardboard that is essentially what gasket paper is made out of, I think. But they make really, really good gaskets. So yeah, I keep on holding on to them, because either you can use them to make gaskets, or you can use them as templates to make fabrication bits out of, because you can make it out of cardboard then transfer it into metal sheets. So yeah, line up against that bottom edge as you would,
draw around it, cut it out, and then hopefully we'll have a nice new gasket. It's not much thicker, but it is thicker, so hopefully it's going to eliminate some of the rattling.
Well, it ain't perfect, but it's damn sight better than the original one is, so I'm going to try and fit it. I bought the scissors out with me, so if it needs to be, I can trim it up a little bit. But yeah, it's a tiny bit thicker than the original one was. Obviously it's not frail and falling apart, so hopefully it's going to do a job quite nicely and stop our rattling, which will then improve driving experience to no end, because the vibration just causes loads of rattling just gives you an endless headache. So yeah, it's not ideal. So I've managed to work out how to lift this up, and just waiting to get this last bottom screw out, which has enabled me to get this out and actually lay it in here nice and properly, so I can actually tell it actually fits properly before I start trying to put it on there. And yeah, I think you've got quite a fair bit of wriggle room around here, but generally speaking it does fit quite nicely, so happy days. Back on this again today, chaps. I've just tried and basically work out what the hell I'm going to do here, because obviously I cannot under any circumstances reuse this. It's just all bent up and it's been sort of a disgusting horrible colour like this for ages, and well, obviously the wood effect is there, that's what it should be, but I'm never going to find a bit of that stuff today, so I'm trying to figure out a way of sorting it out. Now I'm just stripping it down. This piece of trim in the front here is literally just like two little studs through the back. You've got a nut here with a like a little anti-rattle washer behind it, so that should now just allow me to lift that out like so. Now I have actually just been out to the car, and personally speaking, I can understand why this part is in there, but I just don't see the logic in it being this wood effect. I can't see why you want to put wood effect, personally. Having it all black all the way across, the same shade, the same sort of texture, looks a lot better. But the problem is, you need this part in place in order to fit the rest of it in there, so I'm trying to figure out a way to at least just make a panel up that will go back in there for now. The car isn't particularly in the best drivable state, so yeah. I'm thinking about maybe purely trying this white, because obviously the rest of the interior and the whole car itself is white, so if you've got a white dashboard against all the black textured area, then obviously at least it's going to match with the white bodywork you see inside the car. Well, that's my sort of logic anyway, so I think I'm going to follow that and see how I get on. So first of all, we obviously need to draw around this, put a full stencil on, then we can get a saw and start obviously sawing through it all. So obviously the tricky bit is going to be doing these big circles, because you'll have to use a, I can never remember the type of that, name of saw, but it goes like that, blade goes along here, and then there's a big loop. You can unscrew it here, take the blade off, pop it through, put it back together, screw it back up nice and tight, and then do your sawing. So yeah, that's probably what I'm going to use for all these here, after I've probably done a pilot hole with the biggest drill holster I've got, because obviously you might as well just do as much as you can the easy way. But this middle bit is going to be the biggest pain, because obviously you haven't got the option of that. So yeah, right, let's just see how I get on, shall we? First step's done. I've drawn my way around it, drawn all the way through all the holes, etc. So that is basically now the rough template. I'm going to basically just do the outlines first, then offer it up to the car, just see how it actually fits. I don't know if you need all the holes in it for actually test fitting, or it's just a pure matter of putting things in it that you need holes for. So I'm going to cut it out, just give it a test fit, because obviously this metal sheet was held in by a sort of little bent over tabs on each, all the way around the sides. So I've got a feeling that first of all, obviously the tabs aren't going to fit around this at all. You're going to have to sort of just open them up and let this rest within the tabs. But at least if I find out if it's likely actually going to fit at all, we know if we're going to win or not. So yeah, let's get it cut out. Here we go. So I ended up abandoning the whiteboard idea. Just didn't look right at all. Looked absolutely horrible, to be honest with you. And it just didn't fit properly either, because of the issue I mentioned about the thickness of it and how it was held in place. Wanting to get the car back in one piece, however, I went out to the shed and thought, hang on a minute, I've got some of this rubber left over that I use for the floor mats. And thought, I wonder how that will look.
So went out to the garage, pulled some out, cut it all out, offered it up, and was like, yeah, that actually works quite well. And it's purely because, to me, it's black all the way across, so why stop there? You might as well just go black all the way across. That's what I think anyway. So I cut it all out, got it all to match up properly and everything else, and as you can see, that is the finished product. I think it's personally quite nice. I do want to do it again, but with metal checker plate rather than this rubber, because obviously you can tell it ain't been done quite right because of the fact you've got these weird edges down here. So I want to get some actual metal checker plate, but generally speaking, this is, I suppose, a prototype of doing it, to just make sure that I'm happy with it and like it. When we had all this bit here out, the glass was all cleaned up, it was all de-dusted. I had to take a speedo cable off to be able to move it around better as well, and since putting that back on, the speedo has actually worked more efficiently now. Beforehand you often had to give it a quick tap to make it come into action, but now it just works, which is always a really big bonus, I think you'd say. So yeah, it looks a lot cleaner. I decided to take out the rev counter because A, it was an absolute pig to push through the hole that's behind the rubber here, because it was actually sort of hacked in there. It wasn't original fitment, I'm pretty certain of that one, because these didn't originally have them, unless it was maybe like a 10S model from Australia, I think they had them. But for this car in the UK, actually, well, yeah, we'll go with that. For a UK car, they never had a rev counter up here. So I thought, you know what? It's a bit of a pain trying to get it back in there. I bent up the old metal one that's behind this rubber, trying to get it all out. So I thought, no, it won't put that back in there. If anything, if I really get that desperate and want it back, I may well make up a little holder and maybe put it here, maybe put temperature gauge down here as well. But generally speaking, I quite like it. It's a very nice minimalistic approach. It's got everything you need, not everything in addition that you don't actually need to necessarily drive. So I really like it, and personally it looks really, really nice. You got the nice black on black, and then you got the nice shiny chrome work. I think it works really well personally, so very happy indeed. The reason why we took the whole dashboard out was purely because I was aiming to get a backlight feed to this off of the side lights. So when I press this button up here, it lights up like it now does. Obviously we took it all out, we ended up finding that the feed from the rev counter up here was actually taken off of the front side light for some reason, don't know. But we got that one there wired into the backlight feed on the back of the panel here, which is brilliant because now it all works beautifully. I then worked out a way at the back of the car to make it all work.